Well, this is not video of fish kills from 2018. This was on Sanibel today. Dead fish lining the shore as far as the eye can see. The Department of Health has now issued a red tide health alert for all of Lee County after detecting medium to high levels. You see them in the orange and red here off the coast. But we might not even know the full extent of the damage. NBC2's Alex Howard is local on Sanibel tonight, showing us how broken sensors are hampering efforts to track the red tide.
I'm on Bowman's Beach on the Gulf side of Sanibel Island, where thousands of every kind of fish you can imagine litter the shoreline here. Amidst an ongoing red tide bloom, FWC is having a hard time measuring levels thanks to Hurricane Ian damaging the sensors they use to track it.
The rotting fish actually feed that red tide more.
As piles of dead fish literally bake in the sun, on Thursday, the only beachgoers on Sanibel were vultures.
We've seen snook, redfish, permit, cobia, even fish as large as 120, 150 pound tarpon have washed up on the beaches.
I met up with Dan Andrews from Captains for Clean Water as his colleagues, along with SCCF and FWC, were out measuring red tide levels. Ian damaged the sensors that normally tell us what's out there.
The bloom that we have right now is nowhere near as bad as the peak of 2018. However, these blooms kind of are pretty unpredictable.
Andrews is worried that more fish could die if water from Lake Okeechobee is released downriver.
You're really hanging on by a thread here as far as not having harmful releases yet. We've heard at least for the next week or two, they're going to be pretty low releases.
If that nutrient-rich water makes it here, it could be devastating for an already storm-battered coast.
Depending on the severity of the bloom, it can have serious economic impacts from charter fishing all the way through the tourism and hospitality industry.
We're local on Sanibel. Alex Howard, NBC2.